debate in Parliament on the Sugar Bill 2016. Today we look at the recent developments in the debate, after hearing from the President, the outgrowers and the Busoga leaders. We talked to Member of Parliament for Bulisa, Stephen Mukitale Bihara. Good evening.
Yes, good evening, NTV viewers.
And we're talking about who actually should we say, is there a middle ground on this? Is it not? All those are questions, but we'll start with one thing. Please declare your interest in the sugar industry.
First of all, I happen to be a practitioner. I've participated as a young graduate when government was renovating Kachira and Lugazi, and when it privatized, I also worked for in terms of procurement and supply chain, in particular shipping, and for the boss, the Madivanis and the Metas. But later, I also worked as a procurement admin for the Bukatet, which was revamped the Kinyara Sugar Works. Of course, as a chairman of Nyoro Parliamentary Caucus, I also happen to be the host of Kinyara and other sugar millers who are coming up in the region. I must thank the president for wisdom which prevailed, so that the contestation, which was about the zoning, at least has been deferred until further notice. Sugar industry is a very good commodity with a very big market in the world, in the region, and it has a value chain beyond just the sugar we drink. You have high value industrial sugar, you can generate power from it, you can make ethanol, there is these other products like which you can make out of sugar, including as a manure to our farms. So as we try as a country in our quest to become middle income and in pursuit of commercial agriculture, sugar growing could be one of the products to help our people move from the peasant trade to commercial agriculture.
Now, Honorable, you mentioned one thing which is very important, and you also highlighted that the sugar industry within our country has a lot to offer for our economy.
Yes.
Very, very important. But maybe look and take a look at the zoning of the sugar manufacturers. Where would you say you stand on this?
Yes, I would want to bring a perspective, because the contestation between the big millers who are for zoning and the citizens and the small millers who are against is as a product of a failed privatization. When government handed over sugar mills to the big ones like Kachira and Lugazi, they had only 51% to allow them decision-making. Government had 49%. The unfortunate part now, including in the Kinyara, where we expected the landowners to have at least 15%, and that case Bunyoro Kingdom, the moment you miss out on the stakeholders, what you can call in the total quality management system, internal customers, ownership, sense of belonging, then the moment the land ownership is not turned into equity and shareholding, it becomes a land grab. The moment the outgrowers, who apart from the nucleus are the biggest provider of the cane, are not shareholders, then they don't have a sense of belonging. And then also, the local management, which was initially running these industries, the moment they're out. So it now becomes a contestation between the big millers, them against us. Mm-hmm. So anybody who is supporting zone, without first reviewing that mistake in the privatization, is naive of the fact that the sugar industry is so sensitive. First of all, it's an extensive crop. It has a very big land take. It is a monoculture. It could have food security issues in the country. And therefore, in absence of diversification, it could cause a problem. So it is very important that these stakeholders who give you the cane, the outgrowers, the landowners, the local management, have a stake. And if they have that sense of belonging, it is a smart partnership. It is a win-win. The moment you start risking the sugar industry to be for the big millers. First of all, you're causing a cartel. It becomes oligopolistic, and that would... why would anybody in the current times be supportive of a monopoly? But also in the sector, we have other risks. We have other risks, like in that contestation, when they don't feel a sense of belonging, you'll hear of sugar burning. So to avoid that kind of scenario, I remember Booker T's recommendation for Kenyatta in particular before they left was that the kingdom would get shares, and even now as chairman of Nyeri Caucus, we still have issues, much as government has given money, 35 billion. People wanted ownership, shares, not money. The outgrowers wanted to be part, and that's why in the best practice, these nucleus industries create cooperatives of the outgrowers, so that they have dividends, in they have that shares. And that's why I think the ATIAC model, much as it has come as a redeeming, as a bailout by UDC coming, it should be the right way to go. UDC should be able to start such projects like Kalangala, such projects like Teso Fruits, projects like Sugar, and then allow a nucleus company which has sizable land for the inputs, which gives the advisory, the research, the extension, has the crop finance, gives the value addition, the agro machinery, and also has the connection to the market.
Honorable, you mentioned a number of things, and one thing you keep saying is the outgrowers.
Yes.
In all of this, what do the outgrowers want? What are they saying about this?
You see, in over a decade, close to decades of privatization, they are losing out. When Booker T came around 95 to revive Kenyatta Sugar Works, Hoiman Masindi was booming. I can tell you, Booker T model, which was a government outsourced consultant from UK, did a very good job. And the point I'm emphasizing here is the local content. In the current milling arrangement, it's unfortunate that we are trying to make it as if the other citizens should be now against the big millers. But I'm telling you, in the Booker T model where I did participate, we saw Ugandan suppliers, we saw Ugandan managers occupying the senior staff quarters. Remember, in these nucleus projects, they provide schools, they have health facilities, in Kenyatta we had a golf course, and Madivan also has the same. So Madivan even has an airport. I think it can even be used internationally. Mm-hmm. So it is important that when you have such a project, you don't put one part of the citizens against the other. We need a model, like I was talking about the ATIAC model, where they are forming cooperatives. And the actual community which will give land will have, that is kind of their stake. So in absence of giving the citizens, the outgrowers, the landowners, a stake, it becomes a problem. And this compares very well with the Kalangala model. So the moment the cooperatives are beneficiaries, for example, Kalangala, every month you have an income. For the sugarcane, we are talking of almost every 18 months you have an income. And it is important for a person who's going to wait for that season to really be mindful. Now, the sugar poaching, which informs the intention of the zoning, is the effect. I will give you an example in Masindi. I'm a very good supporter of sugar sector and even Kenyatta.
Yes.
But if you are buying sugar in Kenyatta at 110, and a person drives all the way from Kamudi, over 300 trucks, and pays 170, 180, what explains this person who has, first of all, bought heavy equipment, who is transporting this cane, the expenses incurring on top of that 180 in transport alone is a lot of money. So what I think we need is that we need a win-win situation.
Would the win-win be a middle ground?
And yes.
Can we best briefly describe what that middle ground looks like?
For example, Booker T had proposed that one time 35% shares to go to 15%, I think, for Nyoro Kingdom, if I still remember correctly, 10% for management management buyout, and also the outgrowers 10%. Why is the question of management buyout and outgrowers very important? You see, a sense of belonging, the total quality management approach I was talking about, for somebody to feel, you see, before you talk of an external customer who is going to buy your sugar, look at your internal customer. Who gives you the land? Who gives you the cane? Who is the manager? Now, if they are not brought on board, why would you expect them to be committed? So I think it is unfortunate that we have ended up with a scenario where these are people who bring us technology, who have brought us the investment. Of course, Madivani, Meta, they are all citizens. I am yet to know right. They could also be citizens because even the Kenyan lady now in Atiak, what we need is to encourage them partner with citizens. It is unfortunate if we made a law that is in favor of the millers, that's for them against us.
But
that would not be a progressive.
It sounds like something that can actually be done, but can we get the owners and the outgrowers to agree to this?
Yes, it is very possible.
How would we do that?
I am not only for national dialogue, but I think even at that micro level of an estate, a lot of engagement needs to be. By the way, there is a lot of other, I've already mentioned, we have struggled to do the PMA, the plan for medicinal agriculture, providing the seven pillars I've mentioned. But models like the sugar estates do provide all this, and that is very important because this is a specialized product. So they have the right research, they have the right extension, the right advisory, they know the inputs that's required. And it will even solve this confusion of saying, I have brought bad inputs, like we are hearing over the Soroti case. By the time the UDC came in, by the time government gave the product, is it the right oranges? Is it the right mangoes? Now, the advantage of a nucleus project, best practice world over, they know what they want. They have proven performance. They are not reinventing a wheel. They have been in this. So it's just a matter of perfection. It's like Mukwano, when he came up with vegetable oil and sunflower, he knows which type of sunflower he needs, whether it's in Kriandongo, in Acholi, or in Lango.
Okay.
So these are models which could actually, and how I wish government stop scattering money in some of these non-working NADs and give money to UDC to partner with the successful nucleus models in every region of this country.
So right
tea
now,
is doing well. Tea is doing well now in Southwest, and you know tea is perennial.
Yes,
so it means for 50 years, the Southwest part of Uganda has an income. So they are becoming transformed. They will become middle income, and they are commercialized.
Yes, Honorable. Due to time, we have to end it here. But one thing that we're picking out, that for every citizen that is watching this evening, those who are manufacturers, or those who are outgrowers, or just any ordinary citizen who has heard of this and seems to wonder when will this come to an end, we all need to be a part of it. We need to feel a sense of ownership in this.
You see, also, I would want to encourage all investors and big millers and my friends like the Madivanis and the Metas to try and have within themselves an arrangement. Because if you disagree with the landowner, you disagree with your outgrowers and the local managers and run to government, then I don't think that's going to be sustainable. Rather you deal with your stakeholders, with your internal customers in the modern management of total quality management, so that government just gives you an environment which will give a win-win, a smart partnership. At the end of the day, you sleep as the owner of the nucleus project, knowing that even the outgrower is concerned that the sugar cane is not burnt and is waiting for his profit, and he doesn't because there is contract farming in this, and they don't have to go do this poaching, leading now to the stress we're having or attempt to zone.
Okay, thank you so much, Honorable, for making time this evening to join us in Talk of the Nation. I have been joined by Member of Parliament for Bulisa, Stephen Mukitale Birahwa, and he happens to be a player in the sugar industry, an economist, as well as a representative of the outgrowers in the Bunyoro sub-region. That has been Talk of the Nation. We're going to take a short break, but we return with more of NTV Weekend Edition.